Hello everybody, welcome to Woo Art. Today, I'm gonna show you the easiest way of making poisonous wave with After Effects. At the end of this tutorial, you'll have a better understanding of making circular VFX results. So, get ready to be excited. Okay, firstly, let me explain how the process will be going. First of all, we'll make three textures for the wave. Secondly, merge them all and make it into a circular shaped wave. Lastly, make it seamless and a bit regular. Alright, let's start. Make a comp for the texture. The width should be bigger than its height. And add a rectangular shape. Just double-click this icon. Change the name. This layer will be the wave, and duplicate one for a mask. Change this layer's blending mode to the silhouette alpha. When you move the mask layer, you can see that the wave layer is clipped out by the mask layer. Add a directional blur. Change its value. Yes, this one will be the original texture for the wave. I'm gonna show you how you can turn it into a circular image. Make a new comp with the wave comp. Change its name. Add a polar coordinate effect to this layer. Then yes. Make one more comp viewer. Adjust the layout a little. Okay, let's distort this image to make it look like a wave. Create an adjustment layer. And add a wave warp under the distort category. By this effect, you can distort an image like radio waves. Change the wave width value. You should put a prime number to avoid the repetitive pattern. Duplicate two more wave warps and put different prime numbers into the wave width. You can change the strength of distortion by changing the wave height. Okay, now it's hard to find any repetitive patterns. Let's make a comp for the detail. Grab the wave comp and drag it into here. I'm gonna make it look like, how can I say, poisonous looking, disgusting texture. So create a solid layer. Put this layer under the wave layer. Go to the noise category and add a fractal noise. Change its fractal type to dynamic. Invert it. Change wave comp's blending mode to stencil alpha. Then both comps have the exact same alpha area. Right? Okay, let's merge them. Go back to the main comp and put the texture comp below the wave layer. Delete the polar coordinates from the wave comp. Create an adjustment layer on top of them. And add the polar coordinate. Change the setting. Feels like the wave comp is too strong now. Adjust its opacity. Okay, now it's time to deal with the texture. Make its contrast stronger. Since this poisonous liquid or gas is spreading from the explosion, it should be stretched at the beginning. You can see the scale setting under the transform category. Unlock uniform scaling. And decrease its width and increase the height. Okay, and I'm gonna adjust its brightness by the level effect. Change the values to give more clear pattern. Okay, it's better. I'm gonna add a vector blur to make it look more interesting. Adjust the details a little. Right now, the mask is too flat, so let's distort it a little. Add a turbulent displace. Change the size and the amount. Okay, now it looks better. Let's make one more wave to emphasize the outline. Duplicate the wave comp. And add the level effect to this. Change the channel to alpha. And clip out the area with a weak alpha value. Let's adjust the details a bit. Okay, it's time to animate the original wave comp. Before we start, there is one thing you should know about the wave warp. When you make a wave warp, the wave is animating by default. So you should turn it off for making this kind of resource. You can do that by decreasing the wave speed value to zero. Turn off three of them. Okay then, it won't be animated anymore. Choose both the mask and the wave, and press B to open up the position property. Click the stopwatch icons to activate animation. This sequence will be a second long. So move your indicator to a second later and press N to change your work area. When you press number 0 key in the number pad, you can pre-render only the work area. So it's good to check a part of your process quickly. Okay, let's animate those layers. The wave comes from the top and disappears at the bottom end. Move your indicator a second later. And move both layers to the bottom. So the bottom layer moves first and the mask follows after and clip out the wave. Like this. Of course, the intensity of blur should change with time. Decrease its value at the end of the sequence. Okay, it's going well. This effect is about the poisonous explosion. So the area of this cloud or liquid, whatever, should expand a lot at the beginning and shrinks quickly at the end. To make it happen, I'm gonna give a short delay to the mask layer. It's simple, just move the first keyframe of the mask layer's position a bit later. Then the wave looks like this. Choose both the keyframes and press F9 to ease its speed. Okay then, let's animate the wave webs. Open up all of them. And activate every wave height animation. Decrease the values at the end of the timeline. Yeah, make it calm. Don't forget to ease its speed. Adjust the keyframes of the wave height. Put them a little bit later. Okay, it's going well. But as you can see, there is a seam. So we need to make it seamless. If you're not familiar with After Effects, it could be a bit hard to follow. So, please pay extra attention. First of all, hide the adjustment layer. And make a new one. Put the new layer under the previous one. And add an offset effect under the distort category. You can move an image below by this effect. Change its X value to 0. Then you can see the seam of this composition in the center. We'll get rid of this part. Choose the rectangular shape tool. And masking the area around the seam. Open up the layer's property. Change the masking mode to subtract. Then the seam has gone, but you can see other seams around the mask. Open up the mask 1. Unlock the ratio constraint of the mask feather and increase its X value. Then, as you can see, it blurs the boundary of the mask. Then the seams are less clear than before. Adjust its size to find the best look. I think this is quite nice. Yeah, it's much better. Unhide the adjustment layer. Now, this is seamless. Okay, let's move on to the texture of the wave. Right now, the noise stays still and it's boring, too static. So let's animate that pattern. Go to the factor noise effect in the texture layer. First of all, we are going to animate the scale height and the offset. So click the stopwatches to activate it. Press U to open up the properties. Move your indicator a second later and change its height and offset. So the noise should be stretched at the beginning and squeezed at the end. It should move along with its direction a little. Don't forget to ease the second keyframes. There is one more very useful property in the fractal noise. That is the evolution. When you change this property, the noise evolves. Yeah, see? You can animate this as well. Activate its animation and change the value with time. It's a lot better. Okay, adjust the values until finding the texture you want. It takes time, but, you know, the devil is in the detail. Okay, I think it's enough for now. Before we move on to the next stage, just change the keyframe velocity. Put 100 to make it move dynamically. It's time to polish the original wave. I'm gonna improve its tension. Right-click on the last keyframes and open up the keyframe velocity window and increase the influence value. Do the same thing for the position keyframes. I think the blur needs some touch as well. In terms of the movement, it's better now. Let's see how the wave looks. I think the masked area is too broad and bold. Let's adjust it by moving the position keyframe in the mask layer. Okay, it's better. And we should animate the opacity or wave layer as well to make it disappear more naturally. We can animate the turbulent displace effect to make it look more irregular. Put 100 into the amount at the beginning and 200 at the end. Okay, we are almost done. Go to the main comp and check the wave. Okay, very nice. Let's change the duration of this composition. Move your indicator a second later. Press N to change the work area. Right-click on the bar and choose Trim Comp to Work Area. Okay. Let's do the last polishing. Add the simple choker to the adjustment layer. We are going to animate this value as well. Put the big value to make it look strong and firm at the beginning. And put small value to make it look soft at the end. Like this. For the last touch, I'm gonna use a CC vector blur and the turbulent displace. Just enhance its look a bit nicer. Add a turbulent displace and animate the amount and the evolution. Okay, well done. Yeah, we made the poisonous wave. But the size of composition is too big now, so I'm going to show you how to render it in a small size. Make a new comp with the main comp, and change its name to something like main underbar render. Press Ctrl+K to open up the composition setting window. Change its size to, let's say, 256 by 256. Okay then, you can get the squared sequence resources from this comp. For me, I reduced the size of Atlas one more time, so the final size is 512 by 512 for 16 frames of sequences. Okay, this is the end of the video. If you found it helpful, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Okay then, have a nice day and see you next time. Bye!